is our contribution to the Clancy Brothers Festival. Seeing that we can't have live music in pubs, and we can't have crowds, so we're doing it just with social distancing in mind. So, hope you enjoy it. This is a song from County Galway. It's somewhere.
Thank you.
Sounds great.
In my day, I could have stole what woman's heart there was a way. I'd sing and dance into the morning, blaze away until the dawning, long before I was the man you see today. I was born beneath the star that promised all. I could have lived my life between Cork, Cove and Yall. But the wheel of fortune took me, and from the highest point it shook me. By the bottle live, by the bottle I will fall.
sailing away, my own true love. I'm sailing away in the morning. Is there something I can send you from across the sea?
I'd rather be deaf, dumb.
story about John Bryan. He was my cousin. He lived with his mother, a widow, aged 94. But she died of a sudden after eating black pudding from a pig that died 3 weeks before. Our poor John was so sad. For the only pig that he had, and to see him dead at his feet, his poor heart was breaking. But he could not waste the bacon, cause himself and his man both loved meat. So a slab of sarty procured, and the bacon was cured, twas hung on a hook over the fire. Such a fine lump of meat, with no best before date, and not a mention of when to expire. In the weeks that went by, every morning a fry. Two pork chops around the midday, for dinner twas bacon, and if I'm not mistaken, twas crew beans and drasheens for the tay. But then, one Friday night, poor John got a bad fright. He heard his man give a bad cough. He rushed to her side, in his arms she died. Her last words were, "That pudding was off." But poor John was distraught, but his very first thought was, perhaps he might not let her go. They'd been together for years, through sunshine and tears, and without her, where could he go? At 15, John left school, but John was no fool. Not a genius at maths or at words, but from a tutor named Bernie, he learned taxidermy, how to stuff wild animals and birds. Now, armed with this knowledge from St. Kieran's College, he got to work with great care. He walked through the night so his ma would look right. He even put a perm in her hair. When the job was complete, he said, "Oh, she looks neat. Dressed in her fine Sunday best, with a hat on her head. If you didn't know she was dead, my God, you'd never have guessed." But a week prior to her death, she expressed her regret to the seaside she never had gone. And she thought an old dip might cure her badly. "I said, we'll go for your birthday," said John. Now, see, to keep her alive till she reached 95, that was his only intention. But first things came first, and John feared the worst when he went down the town for her pension. The postmistress said, "John, how is your mum getting on? I hope she's feeling okay." John said, "She's all right. She had a very quiet night, and she's not been complaining today." Now, it was a July 1st Friday, a right good clothes drying day. John brought his man out of the line. He set her up in a pose, as if hanging up clothes. And he said to her and said, "Ah, she's fine." But Father Welsh came round. John made not a sound, just hidden behind the plum tree. "How are you, Mrs. Bryan?" John croaked.
"I am fine, but I'll not bring you in for the tea."
Well, our doctor rolled by. It was the 15th of July. John backed the car up to the door. He loaded his man some brown bread and jam, and they both set off for Tramore. They reached the seashore about 3:45. John found a quiet spot on the beach. He put out a deck chair for his man sitting there, as if she was having a nap. Gave himself a large paddy, gave her some my way, and put the island's own on her lap. John fell sound asleep, waves rolling from the deep. And the tide crept closer to shore. It swirled around his man's body, spilled her glass of my waddy, but John just continued to snore. About 9:00, John woke with a shock. The tide had come in and moved on. The sun was now low. John said, "Ma'am, we must go." But Mammy was already gone. He looked out over the tide. "Oh, Mammy," he cried, as he watched her sail over the foam. He waved her goodbye with a tear in his eye, then he packed up his stuff and went home. His man's body was recovered, but his deed was never discovered. They just said, "A woman drowned, aged 94. But John, he knew better, and he'll never forget her, or the birthday they spent in drama.
Cancer to
singing in the west. The cattle go down to the stream. The red wing settles in its nest. It's time for a cowboy to dream. Purple light on the canyon, that's where I long to be with my three good companions, my rifle, my pony, and me. Gonna hang my sombrero on the limb of the tree right home, sweetheart, darling.
I'm Thank you. Thank you. Oh,